So here guys, we have seen a number of numericals on the basis of de Broglie hypothesis. Now the idea put by de Broglie hypothesis was proved by Davison Germer, right? So they perform an experiment and they analyze the result. On the basis of that, they prove that yes, there is a wave associated with a particle when it is in motion. Okay, so we will see what was the experiment, experimental arrangement, the result and the conclusion. Okay, so you can see this is the experimental arrangement. Also you can see years in 1924 de Broglie put his idea. In 1927 Davison Germer conducted this experiment, and then in 1929 for his contribution, de Broglie's contribution for putting his idea, he won the Nobel Prize too. Okay, apart from this, there is an experimental arrangement. As you can see, there is electron gun, right? Here you can adjust the potential. Okay, so electron gun from which the electrons are emitted and they strike at the nickel crystal. After striking at the nickel crystal, they get scattered, right? They get scattered like this, you can see this arrow. Okay, so here there is a detector, right? Moving detector. You can move the detector to find the position of the scattered electron this way. Okay, and scattering angle too. Okay, we are going to see all of this calculation later on. This slide is just to make you understand what type of arrangement we are doing. Okay, so what's happening here? A beam of electrons emitted by electron gun is made to fall on nickel crystal cut along cubical axis at particular angle. So we are having nickel crystal, I have just shown that to you, and the beam of electron is falling on the nickel crystal, and of course when they strike to the nickel crystal they will be scattered, right? Then the scattered beam of electron is received by the detector, which can be rotated at any angle. That's also I have told you already, that the scattered beam, that means the detector will detect the presence of electron, right? With rotation, it can be rotated anywhere through any angle. Then energy of the incident beam of electron can be varied by changing the applied voltage to the electron gun, right? I have shown you that too, that the voltage can be maintained at the electron gun to change the energy of the particular electron which are emitting from the electron gun. Now for different scattering angle, the value for intensity was observed, right? And it was observed that at the scattering angle of 50 degrees, right, and the same accelerating potential at 54 volt, they got the maximum intensity of scattered beam. So intensity is maximum for a particular value. What was that value? Scattering angle. Was 50 degrees, and corresponding accelerating potential was 54 volt. So these values were recorded. Okay. Now on the basis of that scattering angle, like you can see here, if this is the beam scattered like this, okay. So this is the scattering angle, okay. Let me call this angle as theta, this angle as theta, glance angle, right. You will get this calculation as theta plus 50 plus theta is equal to 180 degrees. So in this case you will see theta is 65 degrees, which is glance angle, okay. So for nickel crystal, lattice spacing is D is equal to 0.91 angstrom. for first principle maximum, n is equal to 1, that we all know. Okay, so with this, when we have observed various intensities at various potential, okay, for 44 volt we got intensity this way. Then when we increase the potential to 48 volt we got this much intensity. Okay, then we further increased the potential to 54 volt, we get this much intensity. So you can see here this part, it has the maximum intensity over here, and you can see the parts over here. Here it has the minimum intensity, like we get the pattern in the diffraction like this, if you remember, like this. This is the pattern we get in the diffraction, where there is the central maxima, right, maximum intensity, after that minima, minima, then maxima, minima, here also maxima, minima, like that. So the same result we get when the accelerating potential is 54 volt, where phi is 50 degree. Okay. Then again we increase the potential to 64 volt, and we have found that again we are getting this type of result. So from that, what we have concluded, we know this formula, right, lambda is equal to H by P, right, which can further be modified with kinetic energy, 2m into kinetic energy. Now you can replace this kinetic energy with, if electron is there, charge on electron is e into accelerating potential, that way, right. So this is the formula for the wavelength. Okay, then all the other things are constant, like h is constant, 2 is constant, m is constant, e is constant. We got the wavelength in terms of accelerating potential, 12.27 divided by root v angstrom. Okay, and if we have the maximum intensity at v is equal to 54 volt, we will put that value over here. Okay, so this way, for 54 volt, when we have put the value 54 volt in the previous expression, what was that expression? Lambda is equal to 12.27 divided by root V angstrom. Okay, we put that value 12.27 divided by root 54, we get the wavelength as 1.67 angstrom. And when we apply the result which we have got from that experiment to the expression of diffraction pattern, we get the wavelength of 1.65 angstrom. That means in both the cases we get nearly same wavelength. Now these are the diffraction pattern for various number of electrons, like you can see here 3000 electrons, here 100 electrons, and you cannot see clearly where is the diffraction pattern. Yes, in this image you can exactly see how the diffraction pattern is there. Somewhere there is maxima, maxima, minima, maxima, minima, maxima, minima, right here. You can recognize it clearly. And so the graph of intensity here is, like you can see, maxima, minima, maxima, minima, maxima, minima, and so on. So this way we have seen that how this Davison-Germer experiment proved the wave nature of that particle named as electron, right. Whatever result we are getting in diffraction, maxima, minima, right, we prove that with the help of wave theory, right. But we are getting the same result when electrons are scattered by the nickel crystal, right? So both the wavelengths are matching. We are matching the wavelength from diffraction theory as well as we are matching the wavelength from de Broglie hypothesis with that formula, and both the wavelengths has nearly same value. That means it is proof that that particle is also showing the wave nature. So whatever idea put by de Broglie was perfectly fine, was all right, and was proved. We got the result and we have seen how we got that. Yeah, and this maxima we are getting at this voltage, which voltage 54 volt.